Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from the new show Sugar Time, D.D. Carr, Richard Dawson, and Marcia Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78,
Good times to all. Everyone ready?
You should be on the 10 best dressed list.
Really? Thank you. That's very observant of you. And, and it doesn't even match. All right, let's say hello to Ed White and Marianne Henry here. Applause, applause, applause. Ed is the current champ. He has $6,800 to his credit. He's a wrestler from Michigan. Weighs 280 pounds, right?
Right.
And he's 6'7"?
6'5".
6'5".
Oh.
And Marianne, how tall are you?
5'3".
5'3". The two of you just stand up there side by side for a second here. We don't see the tall and the short of it here. There they are. Okay, you may sit down. I now pronounce you short and tall. Yeah. Marianne, are you ready to carry on here? The score is 6-2 in your favor. And he's got one shot at it here. He's got to match all four remaining celebrities. The best he could do is achieve a tie. We'll see what happens right after this. Ready. Last question. Last round. Here it is, Ed. You got to match all four celebrities to achieve a tie. It's the best you can do. Dee, you lay out. And Charles, you lay out. The rest of you, please respond to this. Shirley said, I never should have married a tailor. This morning I woke up with a zipper on my blank.
Oh, I want to answer that anyway.
You want to play anyway? All right, write down a little answer there.
No, I'm afraid.
Oh, all right.
They'll throw me out.
Okay, here we go, Ed White. Shirley said, I never should have married a tailor. This morning I woke up with a zipper on my blank.
Mouth.
Mouth it is. Got to match everybody. Need 4 miles here.
I only have one. I'm
you
sorry.
Only have 1 mile.
I only have one. And actually, from the old, you know, zip your lip. I said lip. Is that close enough to
yes,
mouth?
It is. Close enough. Score's now 6-3. Got to match everybody.
Not only did she have a zipper on her mouth, it was a lock on it.
A lock and a zipper, so she could never talk again. Okay, Richard, you're up to you.
Mouth.
That makes it 6-5. One more mouth, and it's a tie score. Mouth. That's what she's got. There it is. Okay. That means we have to turn off the lights, go to a tiebreaker, and give one question to each of our contestants here. The one who's matched most will be the winner. Marianne, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B.
B it is. B says, the supermarket manager said, even millionaires are getting worried about the high price of food. So now, next to the hamburger helper, we have blank helper.
Question makes sense.
Yes, it does. Perfect. It's a very good, perfect sense. Question. Even millionaires are getting worried about the high price of food. So now, next to the hamburger helper, we have blank helper. Millionaires. High price of food. Write something down on the card because time is expiring.
It air.
Okay, that's good.
I can't believe it's that easy. Why do I always make this show more complicated
that's easy.
Than it is?
All right, Marianne, the supermarket manager said, even millionaires are getting worried about the high price of food. So now, next to the hamburger helper, we have blank helper.
Steak.
Steak helper. That's one of the possibilities, steak helper. Steak helper is what she said.
I'm just trying to do my part.
That's right. You've done your part there. What do you got there?
It's too easy. What's another kind of steak? Filet mignon.
Well, that's steak, indeed. All right, that's two for her.
I don't know if this is a match, but when I was a child, we had a governess, and we had everything. I was very rich. We were very rich.
Yes, of course. Don't interrupt.
We were.
Yes,
I know. A nurse, really. And so we would have beef Wellington helper, which, of course,
beef Wellington helper, of course, is... You did have a governess, did you?
I had two governesses, actually.
Oh, actually, two. Hello, Dee Dee, darling.
Like this.
Hello.
Like that.
How are you today?
What shade of lipstick is that you're wearing? I like it.
Oh.
I'm sorry. You know, I...
Marcia Wallace shade.
Mm. I just get crazy when I'm around you.
That's right. Mm. She just can't resist me.
Steak.
Steak it is. That's four for her.
I thought he was a millionaire, wasn't he?
Millionaire. Millionaires are getting worried about the high price of food, so now next to the hamburger helper, we have...
Caviar.
Oh, yeah. Very expensive.
It is. I myself have never had it.
Oh, you haven't.
So to speak.
I can arrange it so that you can get some.
Sure you can.
Okay, Ed, you want A or B?
Smoothie.
A, okay, you got A. Here it is. Mrs. Farmer Brown said, I think Mr. Brown has lost his mind.
Uh-oh.
Today he went out and tried to blank the bull.
Okay.
Mr. Farmer Brown has lost his mind. Now, don't think too hard, because...
I like to think hard. It's a good exercise for me. I seldom get... Why are you hiding your answer?
All right. We're in the tiebreaker. Ed, you need four to tie again, or five to win. Here we go. Mrs. Farmer Brown said, I think Mr. Brown has lost his mind. Today he went out and tried to blank the bull.
Make love to.
Is that the first thing that occurred to you?
Yeah. Wrestling.
You didn't think of another answer and reject it there. I don't think the audience is going along with you on that one there, Ed.
Back to wrestling for Eduardo.
That's right. You feel you've won enough money and you just didn't want to win anymore, so he gave us that answer. What do you say?
I started to say that he was going to ship the bull somewhere since he was an old bull shipper, but I changed it and I put shoot the bull.
Shoot the bull. That's a common phrase, and
too.
A bunch of boys get together to talk. They call that shooting the bull. What do you say?
You mean if it had been a cow, it would have been all right for him to go out there and make love to her?
No.
I think that's against the law in this country. Oh, Ed, I said milk.
Milk the bull. I think the audience is telling you that that's a definitive answer. Now, you must match your remaining four to stay in the game, Ed. Charles, we come to you.
Ed, thanks for everything. Milk, I'm sorry.
Milk the bull. What the rest of you have? Well, then, we've come to the parting of the ways. I hope you had a few laughs along the way.
A few?
Should we give him the money anyway? All right. $6,800 for Ed White, a wrestler from Michigan. Let's spin a commercial for you and then hurry back. Here we are with Marianne Henry, who's won her first game as $100, and now we'll try for $5,000. Ready, Marianne?
Yes.
We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this, blank, kingdom. Now, if you give us the answer, match up the answer that they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. And for matching their second most popular response, $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. Three of our six ding-a-lings will give you some help here now.
Brett.
Animal kingdom.
Animal kingdom.
What the panel consists of.
Right.
Marcia?
Wild Kingdom.
Wild Kingdom.
Richard?
Present.
That's never
now, wait a
going
minute.
To be third.
An answer will come to you.
Oh,
just
it
keep
will.
Thinking hard. It may hurt you when
just
it gets
second.
To you.
It may maybe one.
Say, see how things answer just keep popping into your head, Richard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the winner is...
On the West Coast.
Keys to the Kingdom.
The what?
Keys to the Kingdom.
Keys to the Kingdom was a play, wasn't it?
And a film.
And
Gregory
a film.
Gregory Peck, as a matter
Gregory
of fact.
Gregory Peck, yes, indeed. So there you are. You have Keys to the Kingdom, you have Wild Kingdom, and Animal Kingdom. Now it's option time for you to choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'll take Animal.
Oh.
They're disappointed. You really think it's going to be Wild?
Yeah.
You really want Animal?
Yeah.
Okay, you got Animal. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 number? Magic Kingdom. What is that?
Well,
anything?
I choose one, didn't I?
Disneyland? Oh, I've never been there. Well, that's the way it is. I have never been to Disneyland. Now, may we see the $250 number? United Kingdom. Well, the top one's either got to be Animal or Wild, doesn't it?
Makes a mockery of me saying keys to the. It could be keys, sir. Couldn't it
could be the keys to the kingdom there.
I didn't say it was.
I know.
Listen, if it's keys to the kingdom, change it right now. I'll sing a little song or do something while you're changing it, okay? Okay, slide it, Ari. Wild Kingdom. You know, this audience seems to be on the ball, and they really applauded and screamed and hollered for Wild Kingdom. Didn't you hear them do that?
I should have listened to them.
Yeah. Well, no, sometimes they're wrong, but this audience seems pretty sharp. Well, you've got $100, Mary Ann. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Mike Dixon. Hello, Mike. How are you?
Fine.
As soon as it stopped, and Mike, I guess you know Mary Ann Henry here, and we welcome you, and in 8 seconds or less, tell us the story of your life.
Well, I'm from Chicago, Illinois.
Yeah?
I'm a newspaper writer. I worked for the Chicago Daily News before it went out of business.
Oh, that was a wonderful paper.
It was a good paper, yes.
How long were you with them?
About 5 years.
Yeah?
Yes.
Where'd you go to high school?
Kenwood High School. It was a new high school in Chicago.
Yeah. All right. Southside. Are you out here now?
I'm sort of looking around for a job here now, yes.
A good newspaper man is hard to find, and
that's
here
true.
Is one in Mike Dixon. So if anybody needs one, get in touch with him. You ready to go, Mike?
I'm ready.
You may have A or B.
I'll take A, please.
A it is.
You should call Lou Grant.
You think Lou Grant could help
We're
him?
We're always looking for a good newspaper man.
Yes, yeah, that's right.
He's good enough to be an actor. He's handsome.
Sure, he is indeed.
Yeah.
All right, here we
Tell him I sent you.
I will.
Are you all aware of the fact that George Washington had wooden teeth?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, everyone knows
failed
that.
Failed the Kress test, if I recall.
But did you know that to keep them looking good, he brushed them with blank?
Brushed them with what?
Wooden teeth.
Oh, I get it.
Wooden.
George.
Wooden teeth. You sure are sunburned.
Thank you.
Have you felt her sunburn?
She's been to the islands.
She's been to the islands.
It's my first tan. It's not going to make anyone's day. I understand that, but it pleases me.
The most tanned I've ever seen her, and she wore a bikini, and you should see the demarcation line.
I did. You know about George Washington's wooden teeth, don't you, Mike? Well, anyway, did you know that to keep them looking good, he brushed them with...
Sandpaper.
Sandpaper is a good answer. Sandpaper is what one would use on wood.
Possibly.
What else could you use?
I said he brushed them with pledge.
Pledge.
What do I know?
Pledge is all right. What are you saying?
Well, I figure you don't use sandpaper if you've got a cavity. And you're just going to file away. But no, I said lemon furniture polish.
Lemon oil furniture polish.
Your old
Very
remedy,
good.
But my mother used
That's
it.
That's right. They used it on wood a lot. Yeah, see how nice your wooden teeth are. Charles?
I combined answers. Lemon pledge.
Lemon pledge. That's in the spray can form. Right. All right, Didi Carr, you know all about it. He kept his teeth looking good by brushing them with...
Sandpaper was a very good answer.
Yes, it was.
Because if he didn't use it, Martha would have gotten a splinter in her tongue every time she kissed him. But instead...
A splinter in her tongue?
I think so.
Pledge. Pledge is used on wooden furniture and all of those products there now. Richard?
Yes. Call
you
Lou Grant.
You
tell him.
Tongue?
No, sandpaper.
Hey!
You tell him.
It's sandpaper. Right. Show us your sandpaper, Marcia.
You're always wanting me to show you something.
Yeah.
Good gravy, Marie. Furniture polish.
There it is. Okay, so Mike picked up one there. We'll come to yours in a moment. Right now, we've got this for you.
Today's consolation prize is our first. The incredible Hoover Power Drive, a self-propelled cleaner that makes vacuuming almost effortless. Another good reason why America trusts Hoover. And you can wake up the music, alarm, or the sound of your favorite TV programs with an electronic digital clock radio, a TV sound from General Electric, and ceilings by Celotex. Choose from a wide variety of patterns, colors, and textures, all so beautiful and easy to install, they enhance any room. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. Okay, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Johnny O, here we go now. This is Marianne's first round question. It says, Mort said, the drinking man's diet is no good. I drank a quart of whiskey a day, and so far the only thing I've lost is my blank. Drank a quart of whiskey a day, so far the only thing I lost is my blank. All right, Mariette. Mort said this drinking man's diet is no good. I drank a quart of whiskey a day, and so far the only thing I've lost is my...
Job.
Job. Okay. You say job.
Oh, good answer.
Well, that'll do it to you. Yes?
A very good answer.
An
excellent
one.
I don't know why I didn't think of that. I lost my mind.
You lost your mind. That would lead to losing your job, but it's no match. What do you say?
Oh, dear. Liver.
Liver is a good one. That'll do it every time. Charles?
That's my car keys.
Yeah. I think you lost your marbles. But Marianne is looking for the word job. So far, the only thing I've lost is my...
Is my liver.
Liver. Yeah, booze affects the liver very badly there, doesn't it,
Richard? The only thing that I lost is my balance.
You lost your balance.
It's falling on my face.
Huh. Wasn't really? That a good answer?
Yes, actually.
I'm very impressed with that answer.
Well, thank you.
Unlike
have a drink.
This answer. Oh.
You don't like your answer?
Well, it doesn't. Well, pants.
Well, yeah, drank a quart of whiskey and dropped his pants.
Lost his pants.
Oh, he lost
he
his
lost
pants.
Them.
Didn't know where they were.
I see.
Well, Reddy, I know it's not like me, but it just, you
that's
know.
Right. You are a risque person, aren't you?
Well,
okay, there we are at the end of round one. The score is 1-0 in favor of our challenger, Mike Dixon. Now, again, has a choice of A or B.
A again, please.
A again. One person does not play, and that is Richard. The rest of you, please respond to this. Did you hear that Ugly Edna started her own movie company?
No.
That's right. It's called 20th Century Blank.
I hate that question.
The home free.
Oh.
All right.
Got it.
Got it.
Got it.
Got it.
You're so bad.
Works for Paramount all day, eh? Okay. Mike Dixon. Did you hear that Ugly Edna started her own movie company?
I heard that, yes.
It's called 20th Century...
Pox.
What?
Pox.
Pox.
Pox, P-O-X.
20th Century Fox.
P-O-X, he said.
Oh, 20th Century Fox.
He said,
Pox.
Well, I think they were looking for a little different play on the word fox, 20th Century Fox. He said Pox. Oh. What do you say?
Well, that's a pretty good answer.
Too smart.
I said 20th century
dog.
What do I know?
20th century dog is probably going to occur quite often here.
Oh, I'm feared so.
Yes. Have you got
That's
one?
That's a good answer. I wish I'd thought of it. 20th century dog.
Okay, Chuck.
Move over in the kennel.
All right. Three dogs so far.
Make that four.
Four dogs to go. Hold the mustard.
Can we have some ugly Ed questions sometime?
We do. Yeah.
We do.
Yes.
All right. So, Mike, you still have one, and that puts her in the catbird seat because all she's got to do is match one to tie and two to win, but now we've got this. We got to hold everything up right here and continue this next time we get together and give you time to think about what you're going to do here, all right? And we'll give you a little time here to point out that Bill Anderson has a record called Love Stories and Other Sad Songs.
That's that, close.
How's it go?
Love and Other Sad Stories.
Oh, Love and Other Sad Stories.
That was good.
That's the new one.
And she's in a play called...
I'm in Dallas in Owl and the Pussycat.
The Owl and the Pussycat, yes.
In June.
And you're wonderful in it.
I really am. I've worked very hard.
Yes. And in Houston in June?
Houston in June.
What's the name of the theater in Dallas? Do you happen to know?
Granny's. Yeah.
And the one,
and the Windmill Theater in Houston.
All right.
And Brett's album is coming out, the 10 Best Sad Stories.
Brett sings very
well. I'm Gene Rayburn, and I hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 78. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Woodson, Bill Cartman production.